2002, mathematicians published a new method to test for primes, and finally, they found a fast way that was 100%. This is now one of the latest things. So this is called the AKS test. And it's pretty much a very similar idea to what we did with the Fermat little theorem. It's very similar to that. And the test is, if you've got a number P, and we are going to do this. I'm going to take x minus 1 to the power p, and then we're going to subtract x to the p minus 1. All right. So it's a polynomial. I'll show you an example in a second. If all coefficients are divisible by p, then p is prime. And if they're not, it's composite. It's 100% this test. I'll show you an example. Let's take x minus 1 cubed. Yeah, let's do that. X minus 1 cubed.
So 3 is the number we're testing.
Yeah, 3 is the number we're testing. We know it's a prime, don't we? But we're going to test it. We're going to take x minus 1 cubed. So that's, to make it explicit, x minus 1 by x minus 1 by x minus 1. Okay. Multiply this out, you get a polynomial called x cubed minus 3x squared 3x minus 1. That's what you get. Now you're subtracting the x cubed, I'm told to do that, and you're, what's that, adding on the 1. So these disappear. It says these numbers are divisible by 3. If it is divisible by 3, 3 is the number we're testing, then it is a prime. If it's not divisible by 3, it is not a prime. And that's a 100% test. So this was really important. This was huge news when they published this. 2002, they published it, and it was huge news because it was a fast test as well. Or it could be made into a fast test. There's a little thing they do just to make it a bit faster, because it does get quite difficult. These polynomials get quite nasty. Just to make it a little bit faster, what they did is x minus a to the power of p minus x to the p minus a. So a is a number, like we had before. And they said this was equal to p lots of something plus, here you go, a little x minus r minus 1 multiplied by something. So that's not quite the same, that's a little bit different. This was actually faster to work with, it makes a faster calculation. And for this version, you need to test a few candidates for a here. You just test a few. And if it passes that test, then you can determine that p, which is what we're trying to work out, try and work that out, you can find it's prime or not. Mathematics is done all day, you know, every day. New mathematics is coming out all the time. And only, well, I say recently, 12 years ago, they finally solved the problem. It is still faster to do our Fermat test. It's still faster to do this. But this is not outrageously slow anymore. It doesn't take us to the end of the universe anymore. So we can actually run this test. It's slower than the Fermat test, but 100%